Hi there everybody, Wycliffe Barrett here, Explained Dedicated. We're at St Mary's Church again, come out for an early morning walk. I thought I'd do a little bit of recording. Anyway, what am I going to tell you about today? I'm going to tell you about Orbex Dundee Airport. Now, Dundee I suppose is as far away from Wales as you can imagine. Wales is on the west of the UK and of course Dundee is in Scotland in the north of the UK. But two Celtic countries, joined by the spirits of the Celts, so to speak. So I thought I'd take a walk up here this morning with the dogs and my wife. She's hiding around the corner to tell you about Dundee. Orbex, of course, producing photorealistic scenery for X-Plane and also producing some incredible airports. Dundee is a small airport in the far north of the United Kingdom up in Scotland. We're going to have a look. So we'll see you in a moment. Here we are at Dundee Airport, £12.67 sterling, 23.07 cents Australian, and if you're buying it in the United States, it's $16.18. Dundee Airport, up there in Scotland, the north of the United Kingdom, a lovely airport, very famous for being close to golf courses such as Carnoustie, Gleneagles and St Andrews. St Andrews, a very famous golf course that's always used in the Open. Anyway, enough of golf, let's have a look at the airport. It's a lovely little place. You're not going to get a 737 in here. You might be lucky if you can get a Dash in or something like that, a small plane. Certainly GA aircraft, helicopters, and maybe a Learjet or two. Let's just have a quick drive around. I'm in the Vito Mercedes van, follow me van, so just have a drive around and have a look at some of the detail. We're just going past the fuel farm there. You can see my headlights reflecting off that building. I need to turn the lights off. Dundee Airport originally was produced for prepared or prepared 3D. But now, as I say, it's available for X-Plane. It looks really, really nice, actually, and it's amazing, some of the detail around here. As I say, it's only a small airport, but there's some really nice features, such as the main terminal building and arrivals and departures. I think we're just coming up there now. You can see it on the left here. And it's got like this feel to it that, you know, there should be a little bit more going on, but there's plenty going on, as you can see there. Welcome to Dundee Airport. Really nice buildings, well textured, beautifully drawn. It's looking really, really good. We'll carry on having a drive around, not forgetting of course that this is designed for True Earth Great Britain North, and so it fits in very nicely with that scenery, photo scenery that has been produced by Orbex, Tony Robluski and his team. So just having a drive around and having a look, helicopters parked up here and there. There seems to be quite a bit of clutter and airport activity going on. I will say you've got to be very careful up here. There's a lot of GA, a couple of guys there. There's Derek and Tony have a chat before they go out for a flight. All right, boys? Yep. The problem being, of course, is that internal roads run out and you end up on the grass, and of course it's very hard to drive on grass in X-Plane. It's really well modeled, and so the vehicle slows down. I had to really rev it, get the engine running a bit quicker to get across the grass. Not an awful lot more to say about the airport itself. It is well detailed. The signage is brilliant. You can read it all very perfectly. Got the new hangar that's been built over here for private aircraft, as you can see, and as I say, it's really done well. It was developed by the Orbex UK team, and I have no details of who that is at the moment, but as I say, I'm pretty sure that Tony Robluski and some of his cohort will have had something to do with this because of the way that it looks. It just looks so good. We're going to get in the air in a minute, but before we do that, it's a highly detailed rendition of Dundee Airport, as I've said. It's PBR modelling across all 3D buildings within the airport. It is a challenging 4,593-foot runway, and it is quite a challenge. It's okay if you're in GA like I am here in a Cessna, that's not a problem at all, you've got plenty of room there. But it is a perfect airport for light aircraft training, and if you want to do a little bit of VFR training, this would be the place to come. The surrounding location of Dundee, the surrounding city, has been well rendered, and as we take off here, heading down the Firth of Tay, you can see some structures ahead of me, quite tall. Those are oil rigs, oil rig platforms that have parked up there, obviously getting ready to move out into the North Sea. As I say, it's designed to blend with True Earth, Great Britain North, and it does very well. Here you see me in the Airfoil Labs Cessna, which is a fairly detailed aircraft with lots of features, and the frame rates over this area incredibly smooth, even with all of this detail, all of these buildings here, and there are an awful lot of them. The airport is frequented by Loganair daily with the Saab S340 to London, so you get flights up from London, and it's used by the RAF to train cadets in light aircraft also. So the airport has quite a number of functions. So you've got light aircraft going in there, you've got GA aircraft, helicopters, private Learjets possibly, although that short runway might be a challenge even for those guys. And it, as I say, it's up there in the north of Scotland. It just looks so good. All the water textures have been redrawn and hand drawn and color matched as well. So everything just fits in perfectly with True Earth, Great Britain North, as I said before. If you fly in this part of the country, then this is the scenery for you to get. If you want it just to add to your collection, the value of this is absolutely staggering. I mean, £12.67 or thereabouts. It's a very, very good value for money. You can find it on the orbexdirect.com or Orbex Central. You can find it there. You can have a good look at it. And there's lots of pictures to go with it as well. So, I think that is about as much as I can say. As I say, oops, I did bounce several times. I came in a little bit fast, but managed to get it under control eventually. That was one hell of a bouncy landing. I should have re-recorded that and done it properly, but never mind. It just shows you what happens when you come in too fast. You bounce quite a bit. Highly detailed, 3D grass looks good. I must admit, Orbex are one of the few companies that can actually get 3D grass looking as it should. Sometimes it can look a bit messy and not that good, but Orbex have done a good job here, and I'm very pleased with it, as you should be also. So there you have it, Dundee Airport from Orbex, and at that price, I think you should go and get yourself a copy of this. It really adds to the area, and if you're flying VFR, then it is ideal. Once again, we'll just have a quick look at the main website page, which is orbexdirect.com. You can get it through Orbex Central. If you've already got some Orbex products, you can get it through Orbex Central, and that's probably the best place to get it from. There it is on the website. Don't forget, my name is Wycliffe Barrett. This is Explain Dedicated. Hints, tips, reviews, all related to Explain. And of course, coming soon, we'll be doing some work, some videos around Explain 1150. I haven't done any at the moment because it's still in beta, but as soon as it comes out of beta, rest assured, the videos will all be produced on Explain 1150 beta. As we said in the past, Wycliffe Barrett, Explain Dedicated, give me a thumbs up or a thumbs down, leave a comment, find the notification bell where you can, and also please don't forget, click to subscribe. We'll see you soon. Take care now. Cheerio.